Hi, this is Bam from magicplan. Today I want to address two of your most frequently asked questions. How accurate is magicplan's AR scan, and how does it perform in a fully furnished apartment? To answer those two questions, I'm going to show you a full scan of an apartment, start to finish, and then I'm going to compare those measurements to measurements from a laser measure. Now this is going to be a pretty in-depth video, so if you don't have a lot of time, you can watch our other video on AR measuring right here. And make sure you subscribe to our channel to stay up to date on all of the latest news. So let's have a look at what we're doing today. Due to current COVID restrictions, I'm working from home, so today we'll be scanning my apartment. With approximately 700 square feet, it's not a very large apartment. It consists of a bedroom, a living room with an open kitchen area, one bathroom, and a balcony. For today's video, I'm using the new iPhone 12 Pro. The 12 Pro has the new LiDAR sensor built in. Now, while you don't need a LiDAR sensor to use magicplan, it will give you three main benefits. One, you can automatically detect walls. Two, you get automatic ceiling height detection. And three, you just get overall better measurement accuracy. So let's get started. The first room I'm going to scan is my living room with that open kitchen area. And to get started in the app, I'm going to select Scan with Camera. Now I'm going to follow the on-screen instructions, and I'm pointing down at my feet to locate the floor, and now I'm pointing at the ceiling, and I'm good to go. I can just point my device at walls, and anytime I see that green tick come up, I can move on to the next one. By doing so, I can locate corners even though they might be hidden behind a piece of furniture. If the app at some point doesn't detect the wall like you can see here, I can use corners instead, so I'm just pointing down at the floor, and the app is locating corners for me. And I can switch between wall and corner mode anytime. Now, what makes wall mode or wall detection really great is it makes it so easy to detect and find corners even though they're completely hidden, right? Now, wall detection is a feature that is only available on devices that support LiDAR or that have a LiDAR sensor. If you do not have a device with a LiDAR sensor, you can always use corner detection that you can see right here. I'm just going to finish off the room by using that automatic corner detection. And the great thing there is it works even though that corner is not visible. So here you can see that flower pot standing in the way. MagicPlan can still predict where that corner is. Now that I've finished my room, I finished my perimeter, I can start detecting windows and doors. And I do that just by pointing my device at a window or a door. And then I can use that slider at the bottom of the screen to define the door or window type. So I just had a glass door. This is a hinged door. That's my main entry door to my apartment. And this is going to be the last door in this room, which goes to the bathroom. And just like that, we finished our first room. And I'm going to take a minute here and just make sure the orientation of all doors is correct. And then we're going to move on to the second room, which is going to be the bedroom. This room is going to be interesting as well. What's a bit tricky in this room is that I have these sliding doors, and the room actually extends beyond those sliding doors. So I have to find a way to actually measure that. I'm going to start off by locating the floor again, and then pointing up at the ceiling. Now you can see here I'm detecting the first wall, and I'm going to point behind my sliding doors, behind that cabinet, and I can actually find that wall in the back, and I just placed my first corner. And by just scanning the next wall, we actually just added the second corner that's behind those doors. Now wall detection will also work if you don't see the whole wall, so I'm just pointing at a bit of wall here, and I just located that corner over there. And just like that, that room's done. It's an easy room, it just has four corners, right? So I can move on to locating windows and doors again, just pointing up at that window. There we go. And then moving on to the door. We've already got the second room. Now I'm going to take that room and just assemble it with my first one. and then I'm going to move on to the bathroom. Now, anytime that you're using the AR scan, you want to make sure that you have the best lighting conditions possible. So if you can, make sure you turn on the lights. So as the two rooms before, I'm going to use a combination of wall and corner detection again to get this room measured. I just located my first wall and I'm going to see if that small patch of wall is enough to actually locate it. Yeah, worked. Fine. Now you can see I have that very small bit of wall here and that doesn't quite look right. So I'm going to use the undo button to go back a step and just place those two corners. Now, even in the shower, corner detection works just fine. And here we don't really know or we can't see where the corner is, but the app manages to find it. Another easy room with four corners, and we're good to add that last door. Okay. So as before, I'm going to rotate that room and just drag it into place and just make sure I'm aligning it properly. And then as you can see, it's not quite lining up correctly. And that's because there is a bit of wall behind there where all of the pipes are running. So I'm going to use the filler wall feature that we have in the app to make sure that we indicate that. I just drag that in there, wobble around, and we're good to go. So now at this point, we're pretty much done. And there's only one thing left to do, and that's add my balcony. It's not really a room, but we want to add it anyway. And we're going to see how the AR scan performs in an outdoor environment. So I'm going to select balcony here. And as always, start by pointing at my feet and then up at the ceiling. If you don't have a ceiling on your balcony, just don't point up. Now, even here, it's a bit messy. It's starting to get winter. But you can see, even though there's a lot of stuff going on the floor, the app is actually able to detect a corner. I'm just climbing across my couch. And because I can't really see the corner here, I'm using wall detection again. And that did the trick. So only one more thing left to do, and that's point down at that corner. And we're done. I'm going to assemble that with the rest of my rooms. And that's my apartment. So that whole process took just under 7 minutes. I was able to capture all three rooms, the balcony, and all windows and doors. So let's have a look at the results. I logged into the magicplan cloud and pulled up the scan we just produced. I can see all of the measurements we just captured. And I can even view this project in 3D. But what about the accuracy? For our accuracy test, I'm going to be using this Bosch Bluetooth laser meter. Connecting one of these laser meters to magicplan is really easy as long as they have Bluetooth. If you would like to learn how to use a laser meter together with magicplan, you can watch a video on that right here. And if you're thinking about purchasing a laser meter, check out our blog post on the three best laser meters you can use with magicplan. So what I'm doing here is just selecting the individual measurements and then taking that measurement with the laser meter. All of the measurements are automatically transferred to magicplan via Bluetooth. So now that we have the laser measurements, we can open up both projects and see how the LiDAR scan performed. On the left, we have our LiDAR scan. On the right, we have our version with laser measurements. They look pretty similar, but let's have a closer look at the accuracy. For this test, I put all of the measurements into a spreadsheet. Now, I'm not going to go into a lot of detail here, but I am going to link this document in the description below. Let's have a look at some key metrics, though. In terms of total area of my apartment, we had an error rate of 2.7%. And on average, for all of the individual wall measurements per room, we were somewhere between 2 and 6% error. What's really interesting to note is that ceiling height measurements were incredibly accurate. We were below 1% error for all rooms. As you can see, you can achieve impressive accuracy with magicplan's AR scan in a really short amount of time. If you're going to use that scan to plan a general layout of a space, use it for documentation's sake with pictures and notes, or even do a material calculation for a painting job, it's going to be more than enough. And if you do need 100% accuracy, just hook up one of these. It's really easy. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you have some thoughts, please do leave them in the comments down below or just write us an email. Have a nice day.